How to calculate number of triangles when the triangle is divided by vertical lines? Just number the smaller triangles and just add this. So this will be equal to 6. So total triangles in this figure are 6. Here it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. The addition will be equal to 10. So total triangles in this figure are 10. When triangle is divided by horizontal lines, just calculate the number of horizontal lines, 1 and 2. So total triangles are 2. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. So total triangles are equal to 4. When triangle is divided by vertical and horizontal lines, initially ignore the horizontal line. Just number the vertical triangles, add it up, which will be equal to 6. And now multiply it by number of horizontal lines. So 1 and 2, 2 horizontal lines. So 6 2s are 12. So total triangles are 12. Here initially we will number the vertical triangles, 3, 4, add 1, 2. This will be equal to 10. Now multiply it by the number of horizontal lines, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 10 foci is 40. Number of triangles are 40.
Now let's check how to solve questions like this. 0.04 into 0.0162. Okay, rather than multiplying it like this exactly, let us make it easy. I will make it 4. Okay, as you can check, there are two places after decimal. So I can write it like 4 into 10 raised to minus 2. Again, make it 162, so it will be easy for us. So to make it 162, I need to go for the 1, 2, 3, 4. So that will be 10 raised to minus 4. 4 into 162, if you calculate, it will become 648 into 10 raised to minus 2, 10 raised to minus 4, it will be 10 raised to minus 6. In the option, it is starting from 6.48, so I need to go back by two places, 6.48. So this will become 6.48 into 10 raised to minus 4. Provide answer of this question in the comment box. Now let's check divisibility rule of 8. I want to check whether the given number is divisible by 8 or not. So rather than doing by a normal method, let us apply a rule of divisibility of 8. What is that rule? If the last 3 digits of any number divisible by 8, then that number is divisible by 8. So rather than checking for complete number, just check last 3 digits. So is 568 divisible by 8? So as we know, 8 into 7 is 56 and 8 into 1. So it is divisible by 8. So I can say yes, this number is divisible by 8. Also, there is one more rule. If last 3 digits of a number are 000, then that number is also said to be divisible by 8. Now let us take some more examples. 9135632. Now just check about 632. Okay, 632 divided by 8. 8 into 7 is 56. 7 will be the remainder. 72 is divisible by 8. So yes. Then 482 is the last number. So 8 means 48. 2 will be the remainder. So no. Then you need to tell me answer for this particular number, whether it is divisible by 8 or not. Now let's solve this question based on simple interest. A sum of money doubles itself in 10 years, it will triple itself. So in how many years it will become 3 times of itself? So shortcut to do these type of questions, suppose let me consider my principal or sum is 100 rupees. So what they have said, a sum of money doubles itself in 10 years. So from 100 to become it 200, it has taken 10 years. Okay. And next, to become 3 times of itself, so to become 300 rupees, how many years it will take? So there is a concept in simple interest. Simple interest increases uniformly. So for every year, it increases same. So to increase by 100 rupees, it has taken 10 years. So to increase by total 200 rupees, it will take total 20 years. So answer for this question is going to be 20. 100 for initial 10 years, 100 for next 10 years. Answer will be 20 years. A man sold two houses for rupees 6,75,958 each. On one he gains 16%, on another he loses 16%. How much does he gain or lose in the transaction? So the question is, man sold two houses. So selling price is 6,75,958 each. Okay. On one he gains 16%, on another he loses 16%. Okay, so many students will feel the answer is no loss, no gain. But always remember, whenever the selling price for two items is same, gain percentage and loss percentage is same, seller will always have a loss. Okay, and rather than calculating it with a normal formula of profit and loss, there is a shortcut to calculate loss percentage. Formula is loss percentage is equal to common loss or profit divided by 10 bracket square. So common loss or profit was 16 divided by 10 bracket square. So 16 square is 256, 256 by 100. Answer will be 2.56% loss.